नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज द सिग्नल एक्स ए ऑफ टी इज इक्वल टू 3 साइन ऑफ 100 पाई टी सैम्पल्ड विथ सैम्पलिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी एफ एस 300 सैम्पल्स पर सेकंड. डिटरमाइन द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल एक्स ऑफ एन इक्वल टू एक्स ए ऑफ एन टी टी इज इक्वल टू 1 बाय एफ एंड शो दैट इट इज पीरियडिक. नाउ इन प्रॉब्लम व्हाट इज गिवन द एनालॉग सिग्नल इज गिवन एक्स ए ऑफ टी. सो given analog signal xa of t is equal to 3 sine 100 pi t. Now the discrete time signal, there is a relation between discrete time signal and analog signal and it is given by xn is equal to xa of t. xa of nt. So the discrete time signal is related to analog signal as x of n is equal to xa of nt. That is, discrete time signal is obtained by replacing t by nt. That is, discrete time signal is obtained by replacing small t by n t. So this is equation, this one is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So from equation 1 we can write x of n is equal to 3 sine of, it is replaced by 100 n cap 100 pi n t. Now what is t? T is sampling time, that is equal to 1 by sampling frequency. So t is equal to, what is sampling frequency? Sampling frequency is given 300. So it is t is equal to 1 by 300. So this is equation 3. Now we put this value in equation number 3. So equation 3 becomes x of n is equal to 3 sine of 100 pi n into what is t? T is 1 by 300. So it is 3 sine pi by, it's 3 by 3 n. Now we have the standard equation of discrete signal. We have standard. What is standard equation? Xn is equal to a sine of 2 pi fn. So we compare this equation. This is equation 4 and 5. We compare equation 4 and 5. Compare equation 4 and 5. So we get 2 pi fn is equal to pi by 3 n. So f is equal to 1 by 6. So this is the frequency of discrete time signal. As it is the ratio of two integers, the given sequence is periodic in nature. Okay. So we can write here, this is frequency of discrete time signal and it is the ratio. This frequency is ratio of two integer. So the given sequence is periodic in nature. Now the next problem is an analog signal x of t is sine of 480 pi t plus 3 sine 720 pi t is sampled at 600 times per second. Then what are the frequencies in radians in the resulting DT signal xn, that is resulting discrete time signal x of n? And second one is, if x of n is passed through an ideal DAC, then what is reconstructed signal y of t? Now here, what is given in the problem? Analog signal is given. So, given analog signal is x of t is equal to sine of 480 pi t plus 3 sine 720 pi t. Now similarly, the discrete time signal is obtained by replacing t by n capital T. So right here, discrete time signal is obtained by replacing small t by n t. So the equation will be x of n, this is our equation, this is our equation number 1. So x of n is equal to sine of 480 pi n t plus 3 sine of 720 pi n t. This is equation 2. Now what is t? T is sampling time. That is equal to 1 by sampling frequency. So it is 1 divided by sampling frequency is given 600. So it is 1 by 600. Now we substitute this t value in equation 2. So it will be x of n is equal to sine of 480 pi n by 600 plus 3 sine of 720 pi n by 600. So it will be sine of 4 by 5 pi n plus 3 sine of 6 by 5 pi n. So we write this equation or this part of equation in the form of 2 pi minus theta. So it is 2 pi minus 4 by 5 pi n is common taken outside the bracket. Now we know that we have sine of 2 pi minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. So this is 2 pi minus theta, it is minus sine theta. So we can write here sine of 4 by 5 pi n plus 3 sine of minus theta means minus 4 by 5, minus minus it becomes. So it is 4 by 4 by 5 pi n, and here it is minus, this minus sign is taken outside. So the equation will be, this is sine 4 pi, 4 by 5 pi, here also sine 4 by 5 pi n. So it will be minus 2 sine of 4 by 5 pi n. This is x of n. Equation 3, and this is equation 4. Now the next is, we have standard equation. We have to compare it with standard equation of discrete time signal. So standard equation of discrete time signal is x of n is equal to a sine of 2 pi f n, that is a sine of omega n. This is equation 5, and we compare equation 4 and 5. So we get frequency dt signal, that is frequency in discrete time, that is dt signal is equal to omega is equal to 4 pi by 5 radians. This is the answer. Now the next part is, when here x of n is passed through an ideal DAC. Now, when x of n is passed through DAC, then reconstructed signal is y of t. Then reconstructed signal is y of t, and we have to find this y of t, and it is given by y of t is equal to x of n at n is equal to t by t. Now by this equation, this is because we have x of n is equal to x of t at t is equal to nt. We have x of n is equal to x of t at t is equal to nt. So we can also write x of t is equal to x of n at n is equal to nt. Since t is equal to nt, we can write n is equal to t by Now we have the value of x of n in equation number 4. So put equation 4 in equation 6. So the equation will be y of t is equal to minus 2 sine of 4 by 5 pi n at n is equal to t by t. So the equation will be y of t is equal to minus 2 sine of 4 by 5 pi, and n is t by capital T. But we have the value of this t. But t is equal to what? 1 by 600, and it is given. So we replace it. Y of t is equal to minus 2 sine 4 by 5 pi t into 600. One t value of t is 1 by 600, So 1 by t is 600. So it will be y of t is equal to minus 2 sine of 480 pi t. And the next problem is, consider a signal x of t is equal to 4 cos of 12 pi t if this signal is sampled at 24 hertz, then sketch the signal and is the sampled signal periodic. So again, given is given analog signal is x of t is equal to 4 cos 12 pi t, also sampling frequency is given, that is fs is equal to 24 hertz. So this is equation 1. Now we have to convert it into discrete signal. So the discrete signal is obtained by replacing small t by n by fs in equation 1. So the equation will be x of n is equal to 4 cos of 12 pi t is replaced by n by fs. So it is 4 cos of 12 pi n by value of fs is 24. So it is 24. So it is 4 cos of pi by 2 n. This is x of n value. Now we have to sketch the graph or the signal. So for that, we consider value of n is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for n is equal to 0, for n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, and n is equal to 4. So for n is equal to 0, 4 cos 0. So it will be x of n is equal to 4, cos 0 is 1. So next is n is equal to 1. So 4 cos of pi by 2, it is 0. Next is n is equal to 2. So these are the values for x of n is equal to 2, 3 and 4. Now we sketch the graph. So this is the graph. N on x axis, x of n values on y axis, n is equal to 0. Now first is, for n is equal to 0, value is 4. So for n is equal to 0, we get 4. For n is equal to 1, we get 0. For n is equal to 2, we get minus 4. So for n is equal to 3, it is again 0. For n is equal to 4, it is plus 4. So this graph shows that the signal is periodic in nature. So here this signal is periodic in nature. Thank you.